Welcome to Dan's On Fandoms. I'm Dan. Man, what an episode Devil's Deal was. The episode gave us a glimpse at the Imperial occupation on Ryloth, and we also saw the return of some unexpected and fan-favorite characters, which I absolutely loved. There's a good amount to discuss with this episode, so let's dive right into it. Obviously, spoilers ahead for the Bad Batch Episode 11, so turn back now if you don't want anything spoiled. Hello, Chopper and the Syndullas. I have to say, I honestly didn't expect we'd get to see Hera and Chopper appear in the Bad Batch, but boy, talk about a pleasant surprise. Danny Girl and I were both smiling from ear to ear when we saw our homies pop their heads up from the ridge they were on as they spied on the Empire. Hearing Chopper's garbled speech and Hera's accent, along with Hera's theme, as she laid on her back and looked up to the sky, gave me all the feels. I love those two, and love that this episode was essentially a reprieve from seeing our homies in Clone Force 99. My initial worry when we saw Hera's father was that the events of the episode would conflict with the canon novel Lords of the Sith, but that went out the window the moment Hera and Chopper appeared. The episode may have potentially contradicted that novel, but we'll talk more about that later on. I think the purpose of this episode is twofold. First, obviously we're seeing the Empire strengthening their grip on Ryloth, but I think we're probably going to be seeing in the next episode or two, Hera's mother, Eleni Syndulla, die, since she's not around by the time of Rebels. Also, I'm glad we finally know her name. Secondly, since we saw Gobi buy arms and munitions from Sid, courtesy of the Bad Batch, I'm assuming the events of what's to come on Ryloth will pull the Bad Batch closer into joining the burgeoning rebellion. Tell me you don't want to see new best friends, Hera and Omega, fighting together. If the Bad Batch return to Ryloth, I have to imagine that Crosshair will do everything in his power to capture or kill them, pushing them into the fight with Hera, Gobi, and the Ryloth Freedom Fighters. Speaking of Hera, I'm pretty sure this Y-Wing is meant to be the same ship Hera rescued Chopper from, which just made me so happy to see. Just love it, guys. I also want to touch on the Empire and their occupation on Ryloth. We've seen several times in the Bad Batch how the Empire makes it seem as if their actions and or occupation of a planet is benevolent, when in reality it's everything but. In Devil's Deal, we heard several times that the Imperial occupation would bring peace and prosperity to Ryloth with the Doonium refinery, which is obviously BS. The Empire tried selling chain codes in the same way. They spin a situation, making it appear as if it benefits galactic citizens, when in reality it merely benefits the Empire at the expense of its citizenry. This is one aspect of the Bad Batch that I've really enjoyed seeing. The Empire is a wolf in sheep's clothing in its early rise in power, and I love seeing that. The Empire couldn't care less about the people of Ryloth or the planet. All they care about is Doonium being refined there, since Doonium is used in the construction of the Death Star. To hell with the people of Ryloth, its leaders, and the planet, so long as the Empire benefits. Now, to go back to Orn Fri Tha and Lords of the Sith. It's unclear if what happened in Devil's Deal conflicts with what was in Lords of the Sith. At the end of the episode, Admiral Rampart set Cham Syndulla up to make it appear as if he killed Orn Fri Tha when the Imperial Admiral had Crosshair shoot Orn in the head. Rampart had Cham arrested for the attempted assassination of Fri Tha, so I guess he's still alive, but my man's cap got peeled back and sure as hell looked dead to me. Lords of the Sith takes place in 14 BBY, so 5 years after Season 1 of The Bad Batch, and our homie Orn Fri Tha is alive and kicking in that novel. I guess if Cad Bane can survive getting shot in the Chrome Dome, I don't think it's too far-fetched to think Orn Fri Tha can as well. With that said, we've really seen the Bad Batch creators play fast and loose with canon and contradicting what's happened primarily in novels. For the most part, I've been okay with this, but I do have to say it's somewhat of a bummer. Like I said, it's unclear whether or not Orn Fri Tha is dead, so maybe I'm just flapping my gums for nothing. Either way, this episode was still great, and there's a couple of other things I loved about it. How gorgeous was it when Gobi and Hera met up with the Bad Batch to cop those munitions? The visuals from that moon, with Ryloth in the background, was just so cool. I also loved Hera and Omega's interaction with each other. Even though Omega was only in the episode briefly, she still was awesome. I love that Tech won't let Omega fly until she memorizes all the components and instruments on the Havoc Marauder, which is so Tech. And I also enjoyed Omega talk about her room to Hera. That was such a great moment. I want Hera and Omega to become best friends and fight the Empire. Lastly, I liked the introduction of Hauser and enjoyed how he's still rocking his Clone Wars armor. After Order 66, we've seen the clones essentially act as robots, so it's nice to see Hauser still has some kind of individual individuality and personality. I wonder if he'll appear again, and if maybe we'll see Rex scoop him up at some point. Would be cool. This episode was totally unexpected but completely welcomed. I love seeing Hera, Chopper, Cham, and Eleni, and I think it's great that we're getting to know more about Hera's backstory. I expect next week's episode is gonna be a rough one, as I think we may very well see Eleni get murked, but I'm definitely excited to see what next week has in store for us. But what did you guys think about Devil's Deal? And what's your thoughts on seeing the return of Hera and Chopper? Let us know down in the comments. If you like this video, please help out the channel by hitting that like button and making sure you subscribe. Follow the channel on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, all at Dan's on Fandoms. Thanks for watching, and stay